Here in Hogfors Commune, one of the things we do really good is, of course, forestry. Here you see timber waiting for its destination somewhere across the world. Here, of course, in all the villages of Hogfors Commune, the forest is being cut, relaid, and ready for collection. Beautifully sorted and ready for collection. Timber after timber, the forest cut, ready to be regrown. The timber waiting to be picked up. Row after row of timber. Firstly, it's very important to understand that all of the timber is graded into the different kinds of timber and, of course, the size of the timber. The size of the timber is depending what it's going to be used for. The labels have now been placed onto the timber. By the men and women that are working here for Storenso, a renewable resource company that is growing the forests, harvesting the forests, and making the timber, of course, into an end product. Let me take you into the forest and show you what's happening. And do remember that the waste also is being used. Even though they may have drove their machines over it, this will be picked up and used in the central heating systems across Hogfors Commune. Let me take you into the forest. We're here as we go into the forest. You can see that the branches, which will eventually be picked up, are completely crushed by the heavy machinery that has come through the forest carrying the timber to be stacked, ready for collection. Well, here thick in the forest is the machine that collects the timber with its huge wheels, piling the timber up. And some of these are massive timbers, but you can see how big this machine is. Getting the timber ready for collection by the lorries, the next part of the process. A John Deere machine, huge. Thank you. The company here is clearing this forest, Storenso, has some of the most modern and up-to-date machinery available on the market. And these men and women work all weathers, day and sometimes even in the night. And you can see the way this cab swizzles round with the machine. Well, he's finished that load and soon he'll be off into the forest to pick up another load. And there it is, a new pile of timber that has taken many years to grow. Off into the forest. And soon, once this forest has been cleared, the new trees will be planted. The land will have a plow that goes over, turns the ground, and the small infant trees will be planted once more. A process that has carried on for generations of generations. Years ago, this was done by horses. Now, modern machinery crawls through the forest. I'm going to go up and introduce you to the man that cuts the trees down. They've all got their jobs here in Hogfors Commune. And did you know that almost 80% of Sweden is covered by forest and farming? Forest and farming is massive in Sweden. And Sweden is one of the highest percentages of agricultural and forestry land in constant use within a country. You see a forest, other people see timber. We see the grass growing, and I see the animals being fed. It's a continuous process that's happened for thousands of years here in Hogfors Commune. And here, a young man literally cutting trees down as he goes, clearing the forest in days, not months, as in the days of the horse. But these are the trees that have cut, and here are the trees that are about to be cut, saving certain trees but can't be cut down. They're automatically graded at this point into the size. smaller ones on this pile and the larger ones on the other piles. And there she goes. Massive trees cut down in literally seconds. Big tree. To us, it's massive. To this machine, it's just a tiny branch. And there she goes. I could feel the ground trembling as these trees hit the ground from this machine. Each one has its pile. So when they put them in the stacks, again, when they get to the factories, certain trees for certain uses. And the way this caterpillar crawls over the ground is incredible. This is the end of the growth for Storenzo, but it's far from the end of the story. The process after the growth, sometimes a 30, 40, 50 years of growth, has a huge process to go through the factories, whether it be paper, timber, and so many other things that these trees are made into. But what I see below me, here, is not wasted. This will end up being chipped and end up being used in a central heating system of some of the communes, towns, and cities around Sweden. This caterpillar here is now almost loaded, ready to go to the stacks. Picking up at the moment the big timbers. Later, we'll pick up the smaller timbers and then pick up the sycamore, all to be picked up by the lorries with different sized timbers to go to different parts of the factory. Well, there we are, folks. Timber ready to go to the factories. And look at the size of some of these timbers. And the waste from the forest, which is all the bits you can see on the ground here, will all be picked up and used, mushed up and taken to heat the water and central heating for the towns and villages around here. So as you see everything here, this is not waste. This is a byproduct of the timber, and this byproduct is collected and mashed and delivered to the central heating systems of this commune. Every day, 7 days a week, literally almost 24 hours a day, the collection of the timber from the forest is taking place. This is not a 9-to-5 job. being put across, and the man has not even got out from the vehicle. And now, automatically, from the man himself in there, it's going to the back of the vehicle. The next lot is coming forward. He has not even needed to get out from the cab. And now this is ready to be secured and the next logs to be loaded. All well organized and extremely safe once these logs have been secured within the vehicle. Well, very interesting.